With IK pinning, it is possible to make an IK handle keep its current position and rotation even if the rest of the model is moved. For more information regarding inverse kinematics, please watch the related video tutorial. The IK pinning functionality is realized by a special operation mode of the child of constraint. The easiest way to set up IK pinning is by using the IK setup wizard, as it configures everything in such a way that IK pinning works out of the box. It is necessary to use the IK handle as target rotation, otherwise pinning won't work for rotations. It is also possible to set up IK pinning manually. Please take a look at the Child of Constraint chapter in the manual to learn more about how this can be done. An IK handle can be pinned by ticking the IK pinned checkbox in the channel section or by pressing the I shortcut key. Under the hood, the IK pinning property is pretty much the same as the regular parent property of the child of constraint. When an IK handle is pinned, its parent is changed to be the root game object, thus making it keep its position and rotation even if the rest of the model is moved. IK pinning works the same way as the regular child of constraint. It also automatically creates position and rotation keys when the IK pinned channel is keyed. When right-clicking on the IK pinned channel, you can also update the position and rotation key values. It is highly recommended to watch the Child of video tutorial, as it explains some important aspects when working with the Child of constraint. Everything discussed in the Child of video tutorial also applies when working with IK pinning.